App Builder allows you to publish and synchronize your apps to GitHub. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can publish to GitHub. We'll review what gets published to GitHub. We'll look at how to synchronize changes to GitHub and how to merge those changes to your existing branch in GitHub. Here I am in App Builder, and what I want to do is synchronize this application with GitHub so my team can work on it. I'm going to click the Publish to GitHub button in the upper right, and you'll see that it says I need to connect to GitHub. So I'm going to click the Connect to GitHub button. I'll log in with my username and password. This uses a two-factor authentication from GitHub, so let me go ahead and type in the code that I just received in my phone. Verify that, and I'm going to authorize App Builder by Infragistics to access my account. You only do that once, so subsequent merges with GitHub or synchronizations with GitHub, I'm already logged in. You can see behind this dialog, there's my avatar with my username. So this says pick a GitHub repository, so I can choose an existing repository to synchronize these screens with, or I can create a new repository. So I'm going to create a new repository. I'm going to call this People App Demo. I'm going to make this public, and I'm going to give it a description. It's the People App from App Builder. And we will repair that. Create the repository. So now this created the repository in GitHub, and now it will allow me to publish this by clicking the Publish button. So now it's going to upload all of the files that App Builder is creating in the cloud, and it's going to push those to GitHub. So it says that my initial version was published, so I'll click the link, and here I am in GitHub. You can see it uses the default GitHub template, and it has all of the tabs that you would expect when you create a new repository in GitHub. The nice thing is we also create GitHub workflows to build your application, so all of the actions will run and you'll get a pass or failure notification based on what just got pushed from the App Builder. If we go back to code, we'll see that we have all of the default files. If we go to source, drill into app, go to home, you can see you have the HTML, CSS, TypeScript, and unit test that was created when you merge this with GitHub. So let's go back to App Builder, and I'm going to make a change. What I'll do is I'll change a theme. So I'm going to change this to the dark theme. It's obvious that this changes, and I'm going to go ahead and republish this to GitHub. But I'm not republishing. I'm actually creating a pull request on the branch that I created initially, which in this case was the main branch. I can do a summary or a description of these changes. I'll just go ahead and hit publish, and it's going to give me a similar dialog. So I can click People App Updates. It's going to take me back to this pull request, and you'll see that the GitHub actions are queued and ready to run. In progress, the check has started. It says this branch has no conflicts with the base branch. I could do what I usually do, add some notes, but I'm just going to click Merge Pull Request, confirm the merge. And now those changes are in the selected branch. And then, of course, I can go ahead and delete this branch. And if I go back to code, you can see in the source folder, People App Updates occurred 37 seconds ago. That's how easy it is to create an app in App Builder, synchronize it with GitHub, and then merge changes to the repository that you created in the cloud. To get more great videos like this to learn how to use the App Builder and other Infragistics tools, click the subscribe button to get a notification when we post new content.